For Krema Media's Polity, I'm Sane Dlamini. Joining me today is the leader of the African Transformation Leadership, Vuyolwethu Zungula, to discuss the ATM manifesto. Mr. Zungula, some of the promises that you make to the voters include servant leadership, African-based transformation, which is Ubuntu, and accountability. Can you tell us why you believe these values are important?
What we are recognizing as the ATM is that the biggest problem that we have is in the character of the leadership, the character of the country. That is why you are going to see a big problem when it comes to corruption, because corruption does not happen in a vacuum. Corruption only happens because the leaders that we have lost the moral compass. They do not recognize other people as people they should be putting first. Go to the communities where you find that communities are burning buildings, communities are destructive to the infrastructure, there's violence. That only speaks to the problem that we have of the value system that is eroded in our country, a high level of moral decay, which as the ATM, we believe that the root of our problems should be fixed by fixing the value system of all South Africans.
And it was also interesting to read in your manifesto that the African Transformation Leadership is promising the voters to capacitate and skill communities with a focus on empowerment of youth, women, and people living with disabilities. Do you have a clear plan on how this will be done?
When we talk about all communities have a number of organizations, whether it's NGOs, churches, youth organizations, women's organizations, the only thing that is lacking, it is support, because those organizations firstly are doing a bit of work when it comes to contributing towards the well-being of the people. So the plan that we have as the ATM is to partner with those existing organizations, support them as much as possible. However, our biggest goal, it is to make sure that these organizations that exist are able to impart the skills on each respective community. We want as the ATM that each and every household must have a breadwinner. And for that to happen, we need as the ATM that there must be centers in those respective communities that would be able to do the work when it comes to upskilling and training people in those respective communities. It can't be, for example, that if you go to villages, you go to small towns, you are not going to get anything that is development in nature. You need to go to the big cities, you need to go to the towns. Same thing, for example, when you're looking at the issue of drug rehabilitation centers, you pick up in those rehabilitation centers. You can't go to a village and find a rehabilitation center. You can only get them in towns. So what we're saying is the ATM is that when it comes to development, let all communities in our country receive the same amount of focus when it comes to development. The rural communities and townships must not be excluded when it comes to development.
And your party also talks about prioritizing cooperatives and other local SMMEs by empowering them and ensuring that they are supported and that they have access to capital markets and municipal procurement. Would you please unpack that for us?
What we want as the ATM is to ensure that the economy of our country is structured in a way that allows a mass participation of the citizens in the economy. If you look at the bigger companies in our country, they dominate almost all industries. Our economy is full of oligopolies. If you go to the cell phone network industry, it is four or five big companies that are controlling more than 86% of the market share. So what we're saying as the ATM is that we've seen in other countries how SMMEs or cooperatives are utilized to get more people actively involved in the economy. So what we're saying we'll do is that we're going to utilize the local government level as a means of transforming the economy, as a means of ensuring that the people themselves are able to participate meaningfully in the economy. In the sense that, for example, in the villages, in the townships, we have a lot of cooperatives run by women there, which are producing, for example, clothes. Now, what we're saying as the ATM is that in any ATM run municipalities, the uniforms that are sold to the schools, especially in remote areas, it will not make sense for those uniforms to be bought from the bigger retailers, whereas the capacity is there for the cooperatives to produce this uniform for the people in their respective communities. We believe this is what is going to help to make sure that the economy circulates amongst the people in those respective economies and localities, instead of the economy or the currency or the money leaving those communities, because those communities are not producers, those communities are only consumers. On the issue of SMMEs, we know that as the ATM, that SMMEs are sidelined in our country. They are paid after 90 days. And basically, especially after this time of the lockdown, many SMMEs have died. So we want to make sure that the SMMEs are used as a means of growing the economy, stimulating the economy. Because SMMEs in nature are somewhat very small. And because they are small, each and every business they have, they want to reinvest the profits. Whereas when it comes to big businesses, they would want to invest the profits in other countries. Look, during the time of the COVID lockdown period, Batu sneakers or Drip sneakers, they opened a lot of shops, I think between 20 and 30 shops combined. However, when it comes to Adidas, Nike, and all of those big brands, they have not been opening anything. So that is a way, in our view, that shows that the future of our economy, particularly when it comes to job creation, lies in supporting and creating a market for SMMEs.
Now, what would you say to the voters who may feel that your party, the ATM, is not experienced or is the new kid on the block?
They should look at our track record from 2019, when we got to parliament for the first time up until now. Even though it was the first time for us being in parliament, but the strides we've taken and the issues that we've raised clearly shows that the heart is in the right place, because a person can have all of the experience, can have all of the qualifications, but if their heart is not in the right place, all of that experience counts for nothing. So for us as the ATM, that is why we're saying our heart is in the right place, and we are going to push for all of the transformation that we need, because we've got the best intentions for our country. Secondly, when it comes to running municipalities, we want as the ATM to attract skilled professionals, because it is the technocrats or the officials that run the municipalities. The political heads only give political direction. So we believe that the issues that we've been raising, particularly on making sure that we utilize the local government as a means of addressing all of the national problems that we have, that is a political direction that is sufficient. Now we're going to attract skilled professionals by depoliticizing that space, the local government space, and by making sure that those professionals are able to do their work and without fear of victimization, without fear of being ill-treated, because that is what is happening currently in other political, in other local municipalities.
And on the issue of health, you share that public health facilities, they remain the only option for more than 42 million citizens who don't have private health insurances. How are you planning to change this trajectory?
For us as the ATM, we believe that we need to make sure that the distance one person has to travel in order to access a clinic should not be very, very far, in the sense that other people would rather sleep at home and just absorb the pain in order to wake up the next morning to go to a clinic, because the clinics are very far. So that is the first thing that we are addressing, the proximity. Secondly, we are going to address the issue of professionalism to make sure that when a person goes to a clinic or a hospital, they are not made to feel as if they've done something wrong, because we want to introduce a culture whereby all people are treated with respect, all people are treated with dignity. And lastly, want to address the issue of the times of closure of these clinics, particularly in remote areas, because it can't be that the clinics will close in the evening, whereas a hospital whereby if a person can't get to a clinic is 30 or 50 kilometers away, and during the night, the roads, the transport, and public transport is not available. Therefore, the people will not necessarily get the healthcare that they need. So those are the issues that we're raising as the ATM.
Are there municipalities that you are confident that the ATM will win?
All of the municipalities that are contesting, we are contesting only with one objective, which is to win them. We are not contesting for the sake of contesting. Ever since we got to Parliament since 2019, we got good feedback. That is why we are contesting all municipalities in Gauteng, Eastern Cape, Free State, Mpumalanga, Northwest, because it is a sign that the people from those areas said, you as the ATM, you have done well. And because you've done well, we want you to participate in these local government elections in all areas. So we're very confident heading to these elections.
Are you confident that your ward councillor representatives are going to make sure that the services are delivered in the communities?
Our selection process for the ward councillor candidates, it was a vigorous process whereby the party had to select three people, a minimum of three people, which would be taken to the respective stakeholders in all communities, and traditional leadership where they are, and religious sector, women's organizations, youth organizations, Stockfeld, and the business forums, because we believe that ours is to have people who are servants of the people, not have councillors or candidates who are aloof and are not in touch with the realities of their communities. Fortunately for me, I've seen firsthand how our system has worked in terms of making sure that the people are properly represented. Because I've been going, particularly in the last week, campaigning in the respective wards, and I've been walking street by street with our candidates. And more often than not, firstly, our candidate is known and the community speaks well of our candidate, because we made sure that we choose people who have the backing of the communities, because that is what a councillor ought to be, a representative of the people.
And are you going to make sure that once they win in the respective wards where you are contesting, that they remain in those communities?
Definitely. You know, one of the things that we are going to do is that we already have a set program on the 5th to the 7th of November this year, which is immediately after the elections, whereby all our councillors will receive training. So the training, firstly, will speak to their ethics and their morality, how they ought to remain with the people. And that is one of the things that will be covered. The training will also focus on making sure that they get to be capacitated on the functioning of local government, whereby they know the statutes, the processes, etc. Then lastly, we'll also focus on the upskilling of the education of those councillors so that they are able to read budgets, they are able to interrogate reports so that they are able to best serve the people. So we've got a proper plan as the ATM to capacitate and upskill our councillors. The fact that a person has been elected is not a matter of celebration to us at the ATM, but it's a matter of going down and saying, all right, this is where we are. This is how we need to upskill. Fortunately, I'm leading by example because I'm still staying where I used to stay before I got to be elected as a member of parliament. I've registered, I finished my honors degree earlier this year. Currently, I'm doing my master's. So we as the ATM, we are serious. That is why our actions speak louder than what we say.
Wow, congratulations. To that achievement, Mr. Zungula. And lastly, what would you say now to encourage South Africans to go out in numbers to vote?
The people of our country must recognize that the power of voting, it is a power that should not be undermined. We've seen how changes were in the African continent when it comes to government and the ruling parties, that the ruling parties have changed simply because people went out in numbers to vote. Even in our country in 1994, when people were not happy with the National Party, they went out to vote in numbers for the current ruling party. Therefore, there is so much power that lies in voting. That is why the ruling party will come closer to the time of elections with food parcels, t-shirts, and with water tanks, trying to create that impression that they are doing something. It's because they know the power of voting. So for us as the ATM, we want to encourage people to go out and vote, because if people do not vote, then they surrender the right, they surrender the power of choosing their leaders to a selected few, and that selected few most often do not act in the best interest of the people. And if we look at, were to look at the stats, there's more than 17 million South African citizens who don't vote, whereas the current ruling party is ruling our country because it got voted for by 10 million people. So people, regardless whether they were despondent or discouraged by the actions and the lack of proper governance by the current ruling party, they need to change their votes. If you are in a relationship and you are not happy, you move on. You do not blame all men and you say all men are the same, because you got to be disappointed by one man, because other men will genuinely love you, they'll take care of you, they'll provide for you, and they'll protect you. And us as the ATM, we're that government that will protect, provide, and genuinely love the people of our country. So people must go out in numbers and vote for the African transformation movement.
That was the ATM leader in conversation with Polity about the ATM manifesto.